Hello friends, this video is all about meristematic tissue, and the first subheading under meristematic tissue is classification. And we will classify meristematic tissue first on the basis of origin of initiating cells, that is the cells which are initiating in the formation of meristematic tissue. The first type of initiating cell is promeristem or primordial meristem. Promeristem is the site of new growth in a plant body where formation of new organs take place. So promeristem or primordial meristem is basically the site or region of new growth in a plant body where formation of new organs take place. Second point, sometimes it is also known as embryonic meristem. So promeristem or primordial meristem is also known as embryonic meristem. So embryo is the start or origin of a new life in animal or in plant kingdom. So promeristem or primordial meristem is also known as embryonic meristem. The cells of this region are isodiametric, thin-walled, vacuolated or non-vacuolated, dense cytoplasm, and early stages of pits are also present. Pits, I won't give you the full definition of pits here, but just remember these are small voids or spaces found in plant cells. Why they are formed, when they are formed, that will be our future topic. So the cells of this region are isodiametric, thin-walled, vacuolated or non-vacuolated, dense cytoplasm, and early stages of pits are present. Prominent nuclei and inconspicuous intercellular spaces are seen. So nuclei or nucleus is very prominent, but the intercellular spaces are not so prominent or inconspicuous, or you can ignore if there are some spaces, or the intercellular spaces are very negligible, therefore inconspicuous. Promeristem forms primary meristem. So from promeristem, primary meristem originates. The second type of initiating cell is primary meristem, which we get from promeristem. So primary meristem, the first derivative of the promeristem. So primary meristem is the first derivative or the first formed initiating cell from the primary, from the promeristem or primordial meristem. Primary meristem forms fundamental parts of the plant, which are shoot apical meristem or commonly known as SAM, S-A-M, root apical meristem or commonly known as RAM or RAM, and leaf primordia. So these three are the fundamental parts of the plant body, which are formed by the activity of primary meristem. Cells divide in all possible plane. You can see the division of primary meristem is not specified or not plane restricted. It is possible in all possible direction. The division is shown in all possible direction. The third type of initiating cell is secondary meristem. After a certain stage of development, this type of secondary meristem is formed. Secondary meristem originates from mature tissues which have already divided or differentiated. So secondary meristem originates from those tissues which have already differentiated. So secondary meristem, after a certain stage of development, develops from mature tissues which have already divided and differentiated. The growth or the plane of division is always lateral in position. This is always lateral or horizontal in position. So secondary meristem divides or grows only in lateral position like this. During emergency, for example, wound healing, if plant is wounded or some cells or a particular tissue is wounded in a plant body, then during that period of time or during that emergency period, secondary meristem is produced, or to affect secondary growth or to form cork. So when does a secondary meristem formed? There are three main instances, which are during emergency or wound healing, or to affect secondary growth, or to produce cork. What is a cork? I am not telling you right now, just remember this word. So secondary meristem is basically needed during emergency to affect secondary growth or to form cork. Last point, appears later at a stage of development of an organ. So after the formation of all the fundamental parts, the initiating organs or the initial organs, secondary meristem is produced. Appears later at a stage of development of an organ. In my next video, I will continue with meristematic tissue, and the heading will be classification of meristem based on plane of division. So this was based on origin of initiating cells, and in my next video, classification of meristem based on plane of division. Thank you.